My name is Advocate Madhusudan Shetty and welcome to the first episode of MS Edu Venture. Today, we have chosen to talk about COVID-19 and its legal implications that we're seeing across the country. As we know, 16,000 and more victims have fallen fatality to this dreaded disease, this dreaded virus, and social distancing seems to be the only solution to it. Talking about social distancing, we had an appeal made by the Honorable Prime Minister a few days back asking for Janta curfew, self-imposed curfew. Okay, this did receive an overwhelming response. But come the next few days, there was a sudden surge in fresh cases which set the alarms ringing. So state governments this time had to act. As we know, public order and police comes under the state list, that is entry 1 and 2. And further, criminal law and criminal procedure comes under entry 1 and 2 of the concurrent list of Schedule 7 of the Constitution. State governments across the country have resorted to Section 144 of CrPC to curb this menace. Now, what is this Section 144 that we keep on talking about, that we hear all these days? Further, the punishment of the offences are defined in Section 188, Section 270, Section 271 of Indian Penal Code. Now, what is this we are talking about? Let's go step by step. Section 144. Curfew is not specifically defined under CrPC, that is Criminal Procedure Code. However, Section 144 essentially talks about curfew. It says that if in the opinion of the district magistrate, sub-district magistrate, or the executive magistrate who have been empowered by the state government for this purpose, if they believe there is sufficient ground or if there is an immediate prevention or speedy remedy that is desirable, the magistrates can order and written order directing any person to abstain from certain act or to take certain action in respect to certain property which is in his possession or under his management, if the magistrate considers that such a direction will prevent, or at least it will tend to prevent, any obstruction, annoyance or injury to any person who has been lawfully employed, or if it causes danger to public health, life or safety, or it prevents public disturbance of public tranquility or a riot or an affray. Now, this order under Section 144 of CrPC in the times of emergency can be given ex parte, that is without giving a notice to the affected persons. Once this order is given, it can remain in force for a period of 2 months unless it is extended for a further period of 6 months from the date of the specific extension. Now, what are the implications if we do not follow this order? What will happen? What is the punishment? CrPC talks about the procedure. It's a procedural law. The substantive part of it, the punishments are defined in Indian Penal Code 1860. So with respect to Section 144 of CrPC, we talk about Section 188 of Indian Penal Code, which says anyone who defies or who disobeys the order passed under Section 144 will be punishable. And what are the punishments? The punishment says that anyone who causes disobedience of the impugned Section 144, the direction given under Section 144, will be punished for a punishment of a simple imprisonment for a period of 2 months, which can extend up to 2 months, or maybe a fine of rupees 200 or with both. Yes. Now, this punishment is only if this disobedience causes maybe an obstruction or an annoyance or an injury to a person who is lawfully employed or causes risk of the same. But this punishment gets aggravated, and this there would be imprisonment of either type. When I say either type, it could be simple imprisonment or a rigorous imprisonment for a period which may extend up to 6 months, or with a fine which may extend up to 2000 rupees or with both, if this disobedience causes danger to public health, life or safety, or it causes riot or an affray. Now, there are 4 quintessential ingredients to invite this Section 188's punishment. Number one, the first thing, there has to be an order promulgated by a public servant. Now, in this case, when we say public servant, it would be the police. The second condition is that the officer or the public servant should be lawfully empowered to promulgate such an order, to implement such an order. Third, the person should have knowledge of this order. Such an order has come into existence. Now, the beauty of this section is, even if the person does not intend to cause disobedience, it becomes immaterial. The only thing that is required that he should have a knowledge of this order. And the fourth condition is that his disobedience should cause obstruction, annoyance or injury to a person lawfully employed, or causes danger to public health, life or safety, or to or causes a riot or an affray. So the punishment is very rigorous. Now, continuing with this recent quarantine thing, right, there have been cases that we have been hearing across the country. Section 270 says anyone who malignantly causes, or he knows, or he has reasons to believe that he is causing a spread of infection of a dangerous disease. Now, such a person, if he behaves in such a way, spreading across disease, he is infected and is causing the spread of this infection, transmission of this disease or this virus in this case, will be punishable of with an imprisonment of either type for a period of 2 years, or with a fine, or with both. Now, talking about quarantine rule, right? Section 271 of IPC talks about disobedience of quarantine rule. If a quarantine rule has been ordered, and if anyone purposely disobeys, such a person will obviously cause spread or transmission of this infection or virus in this case, will be punished for a period of 6 months with imprisonment of either type, or with fine, or with both. Now, when we look at these sections with the touchstone of the Constitution, because Constitution is paramount, we see all these four impugned sections, that is Section 144 of CrPC, Section 188, Section 270, Section 271, does not violate any of the articles, that is Article 14, 19 or 21 of the Indian Constitution, because all these articles comes with reasonable restrictions. So my advice to all of you is to stay home, stay safe, and Jai Hind. Thank you.